We have a little shack over here. Hello? Nope, but not the wooden wall. Huh. He has the same dialogue as the other guy. Maybe not. Maybe I'm thinking of something from Fallout 2. The games look identical. Unless there's sprite, you know, unique sprites from Fallout 2. But by and large, most of the NPCs and things and backgrounds look very similar. They use the same pool of assets. Hey, fellas, can I go in, or is... Watch out for Gizmo and his cronies. I like my boss. Well, aren't you lucky? Not many people can say that. Oh. Door is locked. Okay, so we will have to wait until morning. Now, I believe we can do that just with our Pip-Boy. Everything starts, so let's wait 2 more hours just to be safe. Okay, the bright, burning wasteland sky is alive now. Now this is Killian, he's going to be a talking head, and he's going to be voiced by Richard Dean Anderson, aka MacGyver. Or, if you're not familiar with MacGyver, he was also in SG-1, the Stargate SG-1.
Can I help you?
Who are you, buddy?
My name's Killian. Killian Darkwater. I'm the mayor of this fine town. And who might you be?
I'm Fruitspread. Hmm. Give me the stare down. I know it's an unusual name. Hi, can you tell me about this town?
Well, Junktown's not much, but it's home. Mostly we trade with people or let them forget their troubles for a bit. Of course, we have our share of problems.
Okay. What's
from
the problem?
From outside, we've had the occasional to-do with the cons, but they've been pretty quiet lately.
Damn right they're quiet
inside,
lately.
Trouble's been from the skulls. And I hear some strange things happening down by the hub, but they haven't affected us yet. Knock on my mother-in-law's head.
Let's keep inquiring what there is around.
We got tons to do. The scum pit's on the east side by the entrance. Great drinking place. Gizmo's is near there. And if you're hurting, Doc Morbid's your man. Well, if we're too fast for you, just pass on.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
It is pal, ain't it?
I'm sorry, dude.
Damn sight.
I didn't know that was going to be a sassy... That is actually a perk you can get later on, is you'll be able to see what... I believe it's called empathy. You'll be able to see the what reaction... Man, he is really giving me the stink. I'm sorry, dude.
You bet. May not be as big as some in the hub, but people usually find what they're looking for. Take a look around.
All right, John. He's just got the fuck you eyes, doesn't he? And we've got a gentleman wandering in. And he's starting some shit. Okay, how best to handle this? Because I don't believe I need to use burst fire on this guy. Shady looking gunslinger. Though I would like to end this combat as quickly as possible, so let's just plug him. Kenji is his name. Severely wounded. Okay. So we should be fine. Let's get a little fancy, since I have some action points and I'm right next to him. Let's sock him one in the mouth. Yeah! And of course, Ian has to one-up me. Go ahead and put an end to this, if we can. Stay down, Kenji. You gain 400 experience points for helping Killian fight against the assassin.
Listen, thanks for saving my life.
He's still got the angry eyes.
Now, it looks like we've got ourselves a situation here. I know Gizmo's behind this, but I need proof. You interested in helping?
Okay, since we're on his bad side, let's just jump right into it, see if we can... Man, he's just staring me down. There we go.
Wear a recorder and tape Gizmo confessing. Or plant this wiretap in his office. Either way. And we got him. All right. I owe you. Here's the bug in the wiretap. You let me know when it's done. And good luck.
So, we've got a little bit of a mystery. Well, not a mystery, so to say. So to speak. Like, ugh. Take two. Go ahead and loot him. Please tell me this rifle that he has a low strength requirement. Son of a bitch. We are in trouble. As that bad boy is usually what carries me throughout most of the game. And that low strength is really biting me in the ass right now. But there seems to be a situation between Killian, who is, I believe Ian mentioned that he is the sheriff and shopkeeper, and Gizmo, whose casino is, I believe, one screen north. Yes, it is. And he gave us a device to try to get a confession out of him. Why in kind of this Wild West wasteland he doesn't just roll up on him, like right now, I don't know. My guess would be he has a little old world sense of justice. Yeah, but he says he knows Killian, or Gizmo's behind it. I guess he just wants to have the actual proof. Okay, fair enough.
You again.
We're back to hate fucking me with your eyes, huh? Just want to barter, dude. And he has quite a lot of caps. I don't think we're ever going to need buff out. And since our buddies can't wear armor, we're going to just go ahead and give them that. I do like this about the first couple Fallouts. You can actually just type in.
You bet. May not be as big as
some.
Alright,
I already asked him that. Thanks, buddy. Now, I think the other way to see the rest of his stuff is to actually interact with these tables, but since I've already got him pissed off at me, I really don't want to get shot for misremembering how to interact with the game all that well. So I think I just interact with it, but I don't want to get, like, accused of stealing.
Can I help you?
Yeah, and he should have different... Yeah, his inventory is a little bit different, I believe. We're pretty loaded up as far as weaponry goes. I didn't see any stim packs. Aha! Stare me in the face. How much is a grenade gonna get for me? Oh, that's not bad. Perfect. Yeah, I try to barter items as much as possible, not dip into my caps, as there's certain late game things that can only be bought with caps. Yeah, and this is where his armor is. I already have that armor, so I don't need any of that. All right. Here we go. Last table to check.
Can I help you?
Who cuts your hair out here in the wasteland? So, you see these two items here, the keyring and a basic backpack. These are amazing, and I'm going to want them just as soon as I can. What these two items do, along with these sacks, is that they allow you to kind of create subfolders in your inventory space. So your backpack won't be as crowded. You can shove like all your tools into one, all your guns and ammo into one. It's just ways to organize your inventory, and they are extremely helpful. I'm going to hold on to the Mentats. I think there might be something later on in the game that I need for, would use them for. And just to make things simple here. But the keyring does the same thing with keys. You'll find a bunch of random keys floating around here and there. How many stims do I have? I should have about 20. Yep. I'm good for now. If I use some up in the fight with Gizmo. And or Killian. Unlike newer Fallouts, you could actually steal from the shopkeeper's inventory and not just what they have on them personally. And it is a great way to get a ton of equipment, items, and things if you have a high enough skill in sneaking and stealing. You can, I believe, in Fallout 2, you can get your hands on a suit of power armor within 10 minutes of the game if you know exactly where to run to. And I believe that's a shop in San Francisco. So I'm just going to eyeball the area here. This is the Crash Hotel. And I believe these are prostitutes? And this is the Scum Gang, if I'm not mistaken. Or the Gang in the Scum Pit. I don't know if they actually are call themselves scum. Let's talk to the receptionist. Hello! Welcome to the Crash House. How can I help you? I'm looking for some info. I'm just a hotel manager, bub. Don't ask too much of me. I got 50 caps to spare. Oh, she just swiped my money. Do 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 do. Dang it. I guess she ate my caps. She just jammed them in her mouth and crunched them up in front of me. Before we leave, I believe the idea is that you can pay for a night, and then if you want to pay for a night with a girl, that's also an option. I saw a locker over here. Though I think that is a person's head. Forgot. Go ahead and make sure we're alone before we start pilfering. Okay. Well, that was totally not worth it. Not every locker and shelf will have items, but being kind of a kleptomaniac pack rat, I have to check them out. The spool and the ripped up car seats reminds me of bonfires I used to have back home. There. Barge into this gentleman's house. Hey, how are you? What are you doing here? No, I'm not going to fist fight anybody. Slip of the mouse. Now, I know this gang is up to no good, but I think I want to talk to an NPC up here first. And this is Gizmo's Casino. It doesn't look like much on the outside, but it does have a working neon sign. And here is our soon-to-be next companion. And if there was an actual mascot of Fallout, if you had to choose, number one would be the Vault Boy, and number two would be Humble Dog Meat. And this is where you first encounter him. And this is Phil, and he is trying to get past the dog. But the dog will not let him pass, so... Mister, I'd be really happy if you were able to get rid of that damn dog. Where'd it come from? It was a pet of a traveler. When the traveler died, this damn dog just plopped its furry ass down on my doorstep and won't leave. It's been there for days. Who was this traveler? I don't know. Some guy. Said he came from the east, he said. You're lucky you can get past the deadlands to the east. He ran afoul of Gizmo, trying to interfere with Gizmo's business. So Gizmo and a couple of his boys beat him up and threw him from the casino roof. Traveler broke his damn fool neck and died. Dog was pissed. What did the traveler look like? So here's the actual what's going on here. Very subtle reference. Maybe not so subtle, depending on how you look at it. Well, the guy who was tall, dark-haired, with a little graying around the edges, he was all dressed up in black leather, like that's a good idea in the desert, and carried a shotgun. So who, dressed all in black leather, has graying temples, carries a shotgun, and has a dog companion? Oh, and a funny accent. The dog was his constant companion. Followed him everywhere. Appreciate the gossip. Now, in case you didn't get it, that would be Mad Max, specifically Mad Max 2, The Road Warrior. And like a damn fool, I sold my leather jacket, didn't I? God damn it, fruit spread, you idiot. So there's two ways to recruit dog meat. The easy way that I've thrown away like an asshole is if you dress in the leather armor, like I said, makes you look like Mel Gibson. From that movie, as he'll mistake you for the owner, and he will follow you. The other way is to, in fact, feed him. So, what is that? I wish I knew what these people are talking about. They keep forgetting they've missed. Where did I put that thing? Now, this is the, this is the scum pit, the bar, and obviously since it's like 9 in the morning, they're not going to be open. I don't think there's anything in here. Just a bunch of junk. Broken boxes. Ian, let me get out. Ugh. Damn it, fruit spread. So the other way is to feed him. And to do that, we have to get beef jerky. And I believe that is in the scum bar sells it, I believe. Or maybe Killian himself does. I didn't see it. I wasn't really looking, but you can see, here's a little sneak preview of Gizmo. See if we have a description. This is easily the most corpulent individual you have ever seen, which is saying something out in the wasteland where food is scarce. So, homeboy is loaded. Oh. Oh, Ian, could you repeat that? I only caught a second of that. Ian will comment on different places that you go. Most places, in fact. But you have to be looking at him in order to catch it. I'm going to run back down to Killian's place here. See if I can buy it. Because I would like to have dog meat. He's not the best companion. Yeah, you see, there's Ian commenting on Killian. He's not the best companion in the world, but he does put down some extra melee damage. I really got to get this guy on my good side. Or get on his good side, rather. I better go.
Can I help you?
Is barter gonna be the same thing as earlier? How much to make up for my mistake? I think that's how much I paid for it in the first place. I really don't want to have to waste 300 caps. I could probably sell it back to him. Anyway. Yeah, I was just checking to see, like, really the different tables. I don't think Killian has it. Ah, that ticks me off. I was specifically saving it for that, too. Ooh, a Cat Paws magazine. required for the investigation. Anyway. Oh, thank God, Ian, you glorious bastard. Here, hold on to my sack. I'm clever. Wow. Okay, well. Jeez. That is... Oh, and I know I'm leaving behind that Cat Paws magazine. As I recall, you just collect them. I don't think they have an actual practical use. Anyway. God. Now that my dumbass spell has finally ended. Oof. So now we have dog meat. And we can go into Phil's house. Hi, Phil. Phil, I hope you don't mind. I'm going to check out your stuff. And take it. If you have, and then, if indeed there is stuff to be had, which there is not. Dog meat. So yeah, here is going to be the issue. As more followers I gain, more likely they are to get in my way. Ian, I'm trying to eyeball. Now, I do not believe he is called Dog Meat until Fallout 2, but I could be mistaken. It might be like in Arcanum of Steamworks and Magic Obscure when you get the dog companion, is that it starts off with like Worthless Mutt as his name and then eventually becomes Dog after a few days worth of travel. Which, by the way, if you guys have not played Arcanum of Steamworks and Magic Obscure, it's made by some of the same people that made Fallout 1 and 2, and if you like these games, you'd definitely love that game. So yeah, I have Ian hold my spare guns for the time being, as I'm not going to need them. I fear as though I'm going to have to do another inventory shuffle here, as this is our first major trading town. And I'm loaded down with a ton of equipment at this point. So yeah, we're just going to go ahead and inventory shuffle real quick.